morning, everyone, and welcome back to Barnstable This Morning. Just about 10 minutes past the top of the hour. I'm Sarah Colvin, and joining me live in studio, Assistant Town Manager Mark Ells. Mark, good morning.
Good morning, Sarah. How are you?
I'm doing great, thanks. How are you?
Good. A little cooler out there today.
Yeah, a little bit. A little windy. A little chilly out there, but I guess seasonal temperatures, right?
It is, yeah.
So, again, this is a topic that we've talked about at length, and some further developments have been made, of course, when we're talking about the West Barnstable shooting range, and some representatives from the Massachusetts Environmental Protection Agency were here last week. Tell me a little bit about why they were here.
They were here because the Secretary of the Environmental Affairs had made a determination that a environmental notification form was needed to be filed before the land swap that's associated with reopening the shooting range could occur. And there was a discretionary referral, meaning that they could determine whether they needed it. Sometimes you just absolutely, you've exceeded a threshold and therefore you have to file. Because there was a transfer of interest in land relevant to the conservation lands where the shooting range is located, that determination was made. So what they do as part of that process, besides filling out a lot of paperwork, relevant to whatever the particular issue is, they come down, they meet in the community, they hold a public meeting, and then they go to the respective site, or in this case sites, and do a site visit and look at the project. They take that information back to they're located in Boston, to their offices. They review it, and then ultimately, after public comment is compiled, which is due by December 15th. So if anybody's interested in commenting on this project, you can access the environmental notification form and also the video of the hearing right on our webpage. Go right to our home webpage and you can access it there. It's actually under Conservation Commission. They receive comment, they take all comment under review, and it's both from the public and as part of the process of filing this form. I think I had to file the form with about 20 agencies throughout, the various state departments. And they all comment, compiled, and they make a determination as to what the next step is. It's anticipated that the next step will probably be, either a modified ENF or accept the ENF as filed, but if they determine that there are some major outstanding questions, they could refer it to a more intensive report, which is called an environmental impact report.
Right. So, I understand definitely as this is be part of the process, because I don't think that they would just say, okay, yes, you can go ahead and swap this land without taking a look at it. So you actually, not only was there a meeting here at Town Hall, but they went out to tour the locations, correct?
They did, and the two locations were the Breeds Hill Road parcel, and that is the parcel that is being offered in exchange for the conservation area with the shooting range on it. And so we went to the Breeds Hill Road parcel, which is a parcel that was purchased to protect the environment basically off of Breeds Hill Road. It looks at upland wooded area, it's up gradient of water supply wells, it links in with a lot of green space that the state and the town have purchased in the Hyannis Ponds area, if you're familiar with that, north of the airport. So this is actually a very important parcel to us. It falls under municipal use, not conservation, so it's eligible for exchange. And then on the other side, the parcel that we've delineated out at the shooting range is 16.3 acres of the West Barnstable conservation land. That's basically the physical range itself and the area in which we would restrict access around that range, and it totaled up to 16.3 acres.
Sure. Now, this land swap isn't really the only thing that needs to get done before we potentially see the reopening of the shooting range, correct? What else is going on in terms of the shooting range?
Well, the land swap process itself is kind of midstream here. So with this determination, it still needs to go back to town council. There needs to be a two-thirds vote of town council. Then it goes up to both branches of state legislature for a two-thirds vote And then after all of those, are completed and completed in a positive manner, then we could proceed with the land swap. But that doesn't mean the range reopens.
Right.
That just means that you've taken one parcel out of conservation area and put it into municipal use, and you've taken another parcel from municipal use and put it into conservation. So, the manager from the beginning has said, since he's closed the range, that he will reopen this facility only when, he's dealt with any environmental and operational issues. So we've come a long way in the operational issue side as far as working with conservation to put in place, some more modern standards out at that facility. We also have our Public Works Department working with our Department of Natural Resources to evaluate how the place is laid. The berms are set. There's a lot of discussion in the pistol and rifle range about whether we can have it just open air or whether there needs to be some sort of physical structure to improve safety there over the range. It's like a no blue sky rule that's suggested on pistol and rifle ranges, especially, it appears, people are familiar with West Barnesville, it seems like it's a lot of land around it, and
right.
but quite honestly, we need to make sure that if for some reason a projectile left that site, that it would stop well before, any area that might be of concern. So we need to go through that. We're also doing an environmental assessment to look at the lead. There's been a lot of discussion about that, but quite honestly, there's no surprise of the concentrations of the lead out there. The lead basically hits the berm and sits at the bottom of the berm, and it sits in its almost original form. So we expected to find that there. It's typical of shooting ranges to find those levels. But we also have to have some sort of a reclamation and, if necessary, a remediation plan out there so that you go in, you take that lead out on a logical interval, and you don't allow it to accumulate over long periods of time. And then to look a little deeper into the soil to make sure that it hasn't migrated, beyond the first few feet of the soil. All of that will occur before, again, we reopen this facility, and when it reopens, it'll be safe.
Indeed, and when I talked to DPW Director Dan Santos a little short while ago about this, he really kind of explained the characteristics of lead, and it really isn't one of those materials that can leach down into the soil or permeate the water. So that was, I thought that was a kind of an interesting fact about that. Certainly will be interesting to see what the environmental study pulls up, but I think we're pretty safe. I think that's all.
We'll see how. I don't have a timeline for you. We would expect actually a determination out of MEPA by the end of this month. We will expect results of some of the preliminary results from the assessment that Dan Santos and DPW are overseeing by the end of the month. And we have our next town council meeting scheduled for January 22nd. So I would expect that by the end of January, we'll be having some discussions and have a little clearer direction as to how we're going to proceed.
Great. And if people want to comment on that MEPA form, they have until December 15th.
They have until December 15th. If you're having any problem finding it, it's on our webpage, but just call our office, 508-862-4610, and anybody in the office can direct you to where it is on the webpage, or get your printed copy of it if you're just having difficulties, and we'll be more than happy to provide that to you.
Great. Well, Mark, thank you so much for stopping by and
thanks
giving us
me.
The update. Thank you so much. Mark Ells is our assistant town manager. Dr. Marichkowski, superintendent of schools, is next, but first I will send you out to look at that kind of gray and chilly morning view. We'll be back with more Barnes & Noble this morning.